re-listening to the VOD, but I'm pretty sure I remember the gist of what happens. All right. Welcome back. Last time you were here, some very important threads were added. Unassuming, perhaps, but absolutely vital. My star called awoke to join an old friend of the temple's for a lovely brunch. They went to the Misty Morning and met Riemann Pius, owner of the Blue Wind Training Company in Canada. He discussed a lead with the star called of the rented ship that Maple arrived in, the mysterious halfling boss, and the fake name it was under, Cyprus Taros, along with the ships that come from Echo once under the same name. Riemann offered to let them know if the name was used again, and asked. He had a shipment of food that was being brought in to help deal with some of the food shortage crisis. However, he didn't believe that just accept it due to some very unfortunate issues with the government beforehand. He has had it leaked to some of the Red Rioters that there will be food that is not well guarded here, and he is hoping that with your aid that the Red Rioters will be able to come and steal it. Along with this, a little bit of shopping was done. The Avon plant was dropped off with a druid, one that was not tied to the Avon Corporation. That way it could be studied without interference. Some absolutely wonderful ribbons were knitted by one who will not be named. And I personally am trying to think of what else happened. Oh, some lovely flowers were given, and meaning of that was unfortunately a little misunderstood. Oh, poor Maple. I think that was about it for that session.
Yes.
Oh, actually, important thing was that Kira overheard about a possible ghost haunting, and Quinn discovered that not everything lines up with what he thought about his past.
Oh, right, yes.
You remind me about that ghost haunting. I remember it kind of vaguely, fortunately.
Yes, you overheard at the brunch place. This group of noblemen were basically chatting, saying that they had heard about your man being haunted, the library, by the ghost of Kira who burned.
Yeah, that bitch, yeah, right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You're also cutting out slightly.
Me?
Yep. Every other time. I'm
getting back in.
No. The worst part is, that's a good item for a lot of characters.
Mm-hmm. Oh, another important thing that happened was Val took Nadinia off to the side and showed her a horribly broken down ship that for some reason she seems to is very insistent upon fixing and racing in the sky races that they have every year.
Mm-hmm. You're still cutting out, I don't know.
It must be internet.
I actually updated my computer today for the first time.
Updated what on your computer?
The computer.
In how long?
She didn't tell me this is what she was doing.
Maybe okay,
you're gonna have to give
computer?
Us more than that.
No. She did like the PC updates, kind of like Windows does.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Yeah, yeah. I did that.
Except for Apple.
Yeah, it was
Oh, right.
Software, yes.
Okay.
Software. And I did that.
OS updates, essentially.
Patches you have to move.
Yes. I did that. And I hoped it would help. What?
I'm trying to move patches, but she's being...
Oh, I thought you were calling me a toddler. I was like, what? Oh,
sorry. Patches is just like on my lap, just like I'm trying to pick her up, and she's like blocking me.
Let me try my Wi-Fi real quick, just to see if I can catch this before.
Okay.
All right, Cupcake, you can have one. Come here.
All right, is that any?
Nope.
No.
No.
How about that?
Two.
That was not better.
Four. Five.
What's Chris counting?
I'm giving Doug.
I'm doing obedience training.
Hmm.
Cupcake. Normally I do it for myself, but I have figured out that he just wants me to wait till he says the word five.
Close enough.
How are you doing, Alex? Is your voice cutting out?
I don't know, is it?
So far, no.
Then, nope, I'm good.
Yeah, you sound fine. It's Alicia's. I'm guessing that update kind of fried her computer a bit.
It could be anything at this point.
Sure.
Yeah. Speaking of which, Noah, if you're still able and willing to give me pieces of computer.
Yeah.
I think that might be a good idea.
Okay. I'll have to look into how exactly to do that.
Yeah, I think the result is probably going to be me Venmoing you shipping money, and then you shipping pieces.
I could probably pay for the shipping.
Is this?
So far, so good.
Okay. I'm gonna roll with it. Alright. Sorry. I interrupted. What were you guys talking about?
You cut out as you were computer. Saying. But yeah, yeah, don't worry about the shipping, Lenny. I can take care of that. The power supply, my brother says it's not very good in that it's not from a distinguished brand? Question mark. So, I don't know what that means.
Does that mean it's going to catch fire?
No, it probably won't.
And it's probably fine.
I'm just imagining one of those, like, it's like computer parts, but it's like the third party controllers where there's like random buttons. There's a turbo button and you don't know what it does.
No, it's just from some company that no one's ever heard of.
I have one of those third party controllers.
Yes, everyone has.
I don't know what the turbo button does.
No one does, Alicia. They don't know what it does.
I want to know what it does.
Nothing. It's not even connected to anything, probably.
What, the turbo button?
Do you want to know what a turbo button actually does?
Yes.
It mashes a key.
Ah.
That's what it's supposed to do. Most of them aren't adjustable, so it's like...
That's what I do anyway.
What does it do? Anyway.
That's what I do anyway.
I've never encountered a controller with a working one, but...
So, Nadinia has a ship that's in disrepair. Maple, I think, was running around after the flowers didn't go over as she hoped.
Yeah, she started running. I forgot.
Iris, I think, was just reading a book.
Mm-hmm.
Kira was...
joining the book club.
I don't... Yes, Kira was joining the book club with Maurice,
and Iris. And what was Quinn doing? He had a nice chat with Iris.
Get a snack.
Oh yeah, he was eating snacks.
Right.
After he laughed at Maple and Maple chased him down and punched him.
He's gonna text his mom.
You cannot text my mom. You cannot text.
I snap a picture of the
no.
new form and no. say LOL no. what the f-
No. No.
I start TikToking.
He's doing the floss for thousands of people.
Jesus Christ, Chris. I do the TikToking.
Okay, well then the crocodile that ate your leg appears. And now we got a whole Captain Hook scenario.
There's a crocodile Wait. And a Dinius foot.
I want a gator pet now.
No, oh. You don't get one.
Wait, no, you have to earn a gator pet. You don't understand. I need this now.
You have to earn a gator pet.
Also, I need to cut off my hand and put a hook on.
No, you don't. You shouldn't do that.
I used to be a fighter, but now I can't fucking use any of my limbs.
Yeah, I cut them all off in aspirations of becoming a better pirate.
In a world with advanced prosthetics, I just got a hook.
I mean, I got a peg leg.
Yeah, I know you have that. You could get a nice fancy leg, but your peg leg works.
Mm-hmm. It's awesome. I take it off every night. And then I every night Quinn is around, I'm like I wiggle my peg leg at him.
I pop Yar, my arm mate. Off and like wiggle it back.
Oh, we like those kids that do midnight like sword fighting. But not,
I'm so
but not
fucking
with
glad
penis.
Iris chose the other group to be rooming with. poor Iris, if she was with you guys.
I think the rooming worked out exactly as it probably.
Avast ye, matey. I've always wanted to say that.
Marissa just texted me. She said she'll be able to be on in like 40 minutes.
Oh, hell yeah.
Okay, cool. Cool. Awesome.
What did you want to call your mom about?
Oh, I just realized I hadn't talked to her about the fact that my dad's not my dad.
Mommy, the kids are being mean to me. Can you come pick me up? One of them
More
punched
like,
me.
Hey, mom. What the fuck? Who's this fucking dude? Where'd the money go? You didn't take this, did you?
She's at work.
That's why I wanted to text her.
Well, you can't.
Texting well, call her anyways.
I am being so nice giving you guys sending stones that work way sending stones.
Okay, alright. So call her anyways.
You can, she just won't answer.
I call all my right, mom.
Like- Leave like a dozen voicemail. Messages.
I
you
leave
can't leave a message. You can't leave a message. It's a one and done. These are just fancy walkie-talkies.
Mommy.
Nadinia's phone is broken now.
I start calling Nadinia.
Okay. You call Nadinia.
Want to get what?
Wasted. I don't know. I didn't actually think.
You guys do have a job tonight.
Even more fun.
So.
I mean, it's a stupid one, but you have a job. I mean, so... actually, it's pretty important, but.
Actually, getting wasted would help the image.
So what you want me to do is to go out with you tonight and get as terribly wasted as possible, then go to work.
I mean, we're supposed to do a shitty job, but yeah.
That sounds like the most irresponsible thing that we could ever do. Let's do it. Where do I sign up?
I don't know. I'm sitting in the lobby.
Oh, fuck. All right. I gotta figure out what to do about my boat. I have a flying boat now.
Oh, shit. I mean, let's do that.
It's broken, but, like, I gotta fix it, and then it'll fly.
Kind of flying boat can't fly.
You know what, Karen? Get off the fucking line.
I'm just you've got a party line?
I'm just commenting. Sorry. Sorry, I'll
bitch. You don't like your kind around here. You rich people.
Yeah, cupcakes agree.
Hold on.
Oh, Iris will,
He's too busy reading her book to interact with people for the next 45 minutes.
No, Iris takes a phone call and she probably lets Kira know that she has to go visit her parents, that something came up.
Okay.
Why are you being mean to Marissa when she's not here?
I'm always mean to her.
How long do we have before we have to do our thing?
It's probably around dinner time right now, so you guys would leave in a couple hours.
Okay. No, I'll probably have to go snooping around at night.
So. You do know Maurice is cooking right now.
Yeah.
You have no idea where Val is.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't think that's a good time. Because I need to get somebody's help. Ugh.
God, getting help.
Yeah, I don't know what I want to do.
Alright, well, Maurice is cooking dinner, so you're more than welcome to do that.
Get a jump start on the book club book.
Well, we didn't really discuss anything about what the book club was, so we kind of just said that it existed, so maybe I'll check that out.
She did say a book. I forgot what it was.
Oh, yeah, it was some fantasy version of an actual book. I don't remember what it was, though.
Yeah, Marissa's got a master's in literature.
Jesus Christ.
So she's a book ass.
Why did she do that to
herself? No, not literature. English. English.
Why did she do that to herself?
Because she wanted to.
She's a book ass nerd.
Book ass nerd.
But yeah, so Queen, you and Adenia are going to go get drunk?
Apparently. I didn't really think this through.
Great.
Here's an important question. Do you go to somewhere you know on the lower reach? Do you go to the upper reach?
I don't know. Honestly, Quinn is actually more interested in the boat now that it's been...
Okay, you can go check out the boat if you want. If Nadina will show you it. That's right. Chris is dead.
Chris went to go dog.
He's dead. Okay, well, let's switch over to Maple. You are running through the... Maple?
Yeah.
Maple's dead, too.
No,
everyone's dead.
Not. Right here.
So you were running through the city, you said?
Yep.
Can I ask how? Is it like a jog full blown sprint. Do you slow down eventually? Okay. As you are running by, and it's actually not that far away from you hear some of the absolutely most beautiful music that you've heard. And it takes you a minute as you're running to realize that it's coming from someone who's playing a set of pan flutes.
Yeah, kind of freeze. And she does like the cartoon kind of freeze and then kind of hops back on one foot a bit.
Not the pan flute.
can I try to find the person who's playing?
It's a little hard because the person is surrounded by, like, it's easy to tell where he is, but he is surrounded by a huge crowd. So you're not getting a direct.
Okay, is there an alleyway somewhere nearby that I can change in?
Yeah, there's probably one that's nearby. There's also a roof that you could climb pretty easily.
That's true. I'm gonna climb a roof.
Okay. Just quick. Let's see. I'm assuming you want to do cool flips to get up instead of a straight.
Yeah, yes, please.
Yeah, do acrobatics. Yeah. You get up to the top of one of these roofs. There's like, you basically did like cool flips between these two buildings and used some of the ivy on it to get yourself up there. As you are looking down, you see what kind of looks like an elf. It's a little hard to see with kind of this hat that he has on, but just kind of leaning up against the building playing. Like, he doesn't seem like he's really trying. Like, he had just stopped there to, you know, play a couple notes, but there's just a ton of people surrounding him. And as he's playing, he actually looks right up at you and gives you a wink.
Wrong person to wink at, but she just, like, kind of, like, blinks at him.
He keeps playing, but you hear the notes change. They become, I'm trying to think how to describe it. They become like sharper. Like, imagine like he's a picture. Putting
more effort into it.
Well, they become like, it's weird. They become like Okay, imagine you had a picture and all the colors are oversaturated, but somehow that was coming through in music. Where it's like, it's off. There's like, each note is like a little too much. And you notice like the people who were like, kind of there in appreciation and stuff, they kind of stand there and begin to sway in motion with each other.
Yeah, she's gonna start frowning at that.
He gives you a smile and he plays a couple notes, and I'm gonna need a wisdom save from you.
Okay. What the fuck? Fuck you, buddy. Fuck you, I'm gay.
Fuck you, I'm gay.
So you start to feel it kind of take effect, but you have enough experience to
sorry, what did I miss?
I'm getting charmed.
You're getting charmed?
Yeah.
Except she's not. Hold on.
But you kind of have enough training and enough practice, you know, steady yourself and shake it off. Not to mention that you're well, okay, yes, you're gay, and you're also very used to being in an area just completely filled with charm. You're near the Feywild.
Yeah.
However, in this moment where it kind of a little foggy as he was doing it, you look and he is gone. However, you find a beautiful rose at your feet.
Kind of picks up the rose.
Yep, it's just a normal rose. It's bright. Kind of normal rose. Similar probably to at least one that you gave to Iris.
Did I get a good enough look at him? Or did I just know he was an elf?
Not a super great look because of his hat and how far away he was. But you think you might be able to pick him out from a...
Okay. But not enough to turn into him.
Like, you didn't get a sense of, like, what color his hair was, some of his facial features, that
yeah,
kind
yeah, yeah, okay.
You could do a rough, maybe, but not, it wouldn't be...
Perfect, right.
But yeah, you have a rose. The people that were milling about there seemed to come out of their daze and start walking along like nothing had happened.
She's gonna do like a quick like look over to see if she can find him, but
no, you don't see him anywhere.
Can I jump from roof to roof, or is it too big of a gap in between?
In this area you can, but in most of the upper reach you will not. In the lower reach, definitely, easily.
Okay.
Just some of the buildings are far apart to show off how, you know, rich they are.
Property I own.
Yeah, look at this. I'm on a floating island, but look at all this property I have. I don't use it for anything.
Yay.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, let's jump back over to Chris and Quinn. Quinn, do you want to ask again? Or however Quinn asks.
Quinn wants to see the boat.
You want to see the boat?
I want to see the boat at.
The boat. The bot. The butt. The butt.
Yep, I want to see Nadinia's butt.
Alright, I'm gonna take him to go. I'm gonna go take him to see the butt.
Nick is so betrayed right now.
It's a pretty big butt.
Damn. What are you thinking of that butt?
Unfortunately, the butt has to get prepared. You know what? That's what I'm naming it now. I'm naming it the butt.
We've done it. We've succeeded.
Success.
All right. So we're getting wasted.
Yes. Sir.
You guys go stand in front of the ship for a couple minutes, make dumb butt jokes, and then go drink.
Jesus.
What else are we supposed to do?
I wanted to summarize this beautiful, beautiful bonding moment between Quinn and Adenia.
It was beautiful, wasn't it?
Won't be as beautiful as many shots as I put down my gullet. All right. How many? You going pound for pound with me or what?
I'm pretty sure if I go pound for pound with you, you will have to carry me home because I am smaller.
But you're supposed to carry me home. I am the female here. I want to be princess carried. Princess carry me right now. I'm going to try to.
Okay. Here's the question. Are you in armor?
Of course.
Okay.
Right. You don't go drinking. I protect it, clearly.
So my strength is only 12, so I'm going to go with I cannot carry you in armor.
I'm like 350 pounds right now.
Yeah, fuck that.
I mean, would Quinn even do that? Even try
would
to
try? Would you try? Think, or would you just let me like land on my ass?
I think he'd try to catch her to drop her on her ass if she wasn't wearing armor. But if she's in armor, he's just gonna let her
fall.
Trust fall. Ow. You know what? I trust me just as much too.
You guys still didn't answer. Are you going to the upper reach or the lower reach?
Leeches or reaches?
Okay. I have a question. Do we not mm-hmm. have alcohol here?
At the temple?
Yes.
No, you guys got basically they told you that they used up all of it for the festival.
Okay.
You got big wasted.
All right. Quinn, now hear me out, alright?
Alright.
We're gonna get wasted, but not tonight.
That's fair.
Okay. We're gonna go... What we're doing today is we're buying all the alcohol we can and putting it somewhere on campus.
It's not a college.
It is a college.
It is, though.
Alright.
College here. Of Weaving.
It's pretty prestigious college.
We go on an alcohol run.
Yep, okay. Beer run.
Okay.
Okay. Do you tell Maurice that?
Do we tell who?
Do we tell Maurice?
Why would we tell the dark that we're going on a beer?
First off, because he's cooking you guys his dinner right now. Second...
You know what?
Are you guys just carrying this physically?
I mean, I can.
Sure.
Yeah, you know, just two like kegs in each arm.
Okay.
I'd probably say something if we went past the kitchen.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna.
If you're going straight from the ship, you wouldn't.
Okay. Well, then no, definitely not.
Okay. Maurice is gonna make this beautiful dinner, and only Kira's gonna show up.
We're coming back for dinner.
We're coming directly back.
Oh, please don't.
Kira will have a lovely romantic 5 minutes.
I swear to you, I'm gonna barge in at the exact perfect time.
Great. It's true though.
All right.
That's gonna be on the.
The other reason was in case ask Maurice for funds for alcohol. But you guys do have a ton of money as well.
Would he fund our alcohol endeavor?
How much money did he give Maple for thieves' tools?
I mean, she said.
Oh, fuck it. No, I think I just took it, didn't I? Did I take it? Wait, I don't think I even took it. I think I just said I'd get you some.
Mm-hmm.
How much do a thief thing to cost?
She's like, I don't fucking know.
Yeah, I mean, I think he was willing. To give you like 10 gold or something because he had no idea.
Yeah.
I mean, it's worth like 50, I think, actually. So.
How much is crime?
Free. Crime is free. You just have to be good at it.
But yeah, you guys can go make this alcohol run. There's plenty of places in the upper reach where you can get some nice alcohol. And it's not even watered down. That's for the lower reach. What kind? Sorry, go ahead.
I was going to say, I would probably ask Quinn to where to go, because I haven't been here in, like, a while, so I don't know what's like on the upper reach that's really good and the lower reach is more his thing.
The only places I'll know are in the lower reach. It's gonna be shit booze. Okay.
Yeah, that's fine. So long as it can get us drunk, that's all I care about.
Doesn't light on fire.
That's how you know the quality of the beer.
Okay, I take him to a place that has the best of the shit.
That serves the best of the shit?
Yeah, the best of the shit.
Okay. You take him to a tavern that's near your house that, as far as you know, has the least amount of deaths due to food or alcohol poisoning.
Jesus.
Tastes pretty good.
But what's their kill rate?
Their kill rate, like how many people they killed?
Yes.
Let's see. They've been in business a decent amount of time, so it's like 5.
5.
5.
That's
from food and drink alone.
Yeah.
How about from not food and drink?
Like from people just killing in the tavern?
Yes.
That's probably
it depends. If they get stabbed in the place but they're taken out fast enough. Does that count? Because that's how they keep their numbers low.
Quinn is like relaying all of this information.
Like as he continues to talk, I'm like, this is the best place ever.
Because technically, you know, just because they got stabbed in the place, they bled outside.
Quinn is like telling about every guy he's helped carry out of there.
In that case, then the number bumps up to 12.
All right.
And then he starts to talk about how he usually tries to drop them right inside the door so they die.
Yeah, I was trying to boost this other place's numbers. It wasn't going very well. All
right. The place sounds perfect. Okay, we're good now. I can buy the booze. How much is a keg?
How much is a keg?
I don't mean like your wimpy small keg that you can carry around. I'm talking about your barrels.
I'm trying to look up.
I think that's something you would want to buy wholesale. Go to the ye olde Costco.
No, fuck that.
Costco membership.
Nah, fuck that. We buy it. We buy it straight from the source. This is exactly where I go for the source.
Okay. I'm trying to figure out the math in this because, Jesus Christ. What's the name? Okay.
I think that it does have these numbers somewhere, actually.
Okay.
How much is a pint? Half a gallon?
It would be about 40 gold.
40 gold per keg?
No. Sorry, 40 silver.
40 silver per keg?
Yeah.
How big are these kegs?
From what I calculated just a couple minutes ago, they hold about, I think it was like 8 pints.
That's not a lot.
There's 2 pints in a quart. There's 2 quarts in...
How many pints?
That's
I'm sorry, I was very off. It's 124 pints.
Okay, okay, that's a different number.
I barely know.
I had already clicked off of stuff and you made me do math. Of course I was gonna mix up the numbers after I was.
Okay, alright.
But the number still stands, it's 40 silver.
Okay, and that's per keg, right? And like the 120 what is that? 40 gallons?
It'd be 30.
30 gallons? 30
gallons? 16 gallons.
No, it says half a barrel is 15.5 gallons. So double 15.5, it's about 31.
Holy fuck.
128 pints, 16 gallons.
That's
somewhere. Something.
So she's saying double that. She's saying double that.
Okay.
She didn't multiply it by two yet. All right. So I'm gonna carry like three of those. So
okay.
I'm gonna spend that money. I'm gonna hand that person 2 gold.
Okay. He takes it and tells you can load up in the back.
Two gold doesn't cover the whole price, does it?
Yes, it does. It's 40 silver.
Yeah, that's 20.
Oh, 40 silver, not 4 silver. Oh my god. All right.
Yeah, 2 gold totally covers it.
Listen.
Woo lad.
Together we can do one whole math problem.
Would it make you guys feel better if I told you my job is accounting?
I'm sorry.
Alright.
I don't want to do my job at home.
No wonder you're fried.
Alright, 15 silver is what I'll hand them. I'm a big spender. I mean, 15 gold.
Jesus,
okay.
No, 15 silver.
Jesus fucking Christ.
How do I math?
Marissa's gonna ask what she missed.
Math.
So we're gonna be like
math.
Yeah.
Math. Jesus.
Math and
really
a guy.
That's the name
math
of the pod now. That's the name of the pod now. How do I math?
How do I math?
Math and heterosexuality.
Math and the straights.
Math is sexual.
Alright, so he just tells you to load it up in the back.
He doesn't have, like, them already pre-kegged?
Yeah, they're in the back of the fucking shop.
Also,
she said to load up. Okay. No. I was like...
Are you already loaded up?
Do you want me to pour this myself?
Yes.
All right, I'm gonna go into the back and then carry it out. And Cupcake, it's not that serious. I just want to carry cake out.
There's this stray dog in the alleyway that just starts barking at you.
It's adorable and I love it.
No.
That definitely has flea and mange and 2 types of tuberculosis.
I'll take care of it.
Funny. Little friend.
I love it. Can I have it?
Dude, if you can catch that dog that's been running around the streets for 5 years, I'm sure they will.
I'm gonna attempt to catch the dog.
Sure.
Like, it's had rabies 3 times, it's somehow still alive.
You have to go and pick up Cupcake. You have to go and pick up Cupcake now, Chris. Got real quiet.
Yeah. I'm going to post a picture of what this dog looks like. Yeah, let's go with this one. That's the dog.
Oh.
I'm downstairs, give me a second. Jesus.
It's absolutely adorable, and Nadinia will love it.
What the?
Sadly enough, that's not the ugliest picture I found.
It's not ugly.
Hey, Nadinia, would you mind if you stop by my mom's house for a second?
Go for it.
Okay.
Balancing 3 kegs and a dog.
I'd offer to help, but I'm not carrying that dog. It gave Nick rabies. Twice. It
gave Nick rabies twice. Jesus.
You think it was the dog?
I am choosing to decide that the dog gave Nick rabies instead of Nick gave the dog rabies.
Funny part is, rabies is 100% fatal.
Not in a world with magical healing.
Exactly.
It's an immortal dog.
Immortal dog.
Forever.
But yeah, I want to stop by my mom's.
Sure. She is still not there.
That's okay. I use my key to let myself in.
Okay. Okay. There's the fox sitting on the couch there. It lifts its head when you come in, like, not really caring. But the second it sees Nadinia, it scrambles for the window.
Because of the dog or just because of her?
Nadinia.
That's precious. Rough. He is precious and I love him.
Good sense of dog.
He's the most adorable thing ever, and if anybody questions me about it, I will kill them by breaking their neck.
Okay, but since the fox is leaving, I will just leave a small bag of gold on the counter with a note for the food I took. And it's going to have about 100 gold.
Yep, that covers it, right?
Okay.
Do math.
Yeah. The fox does not come back until after you leave.
All right, I'm gonna leave.
Okay.
Was the state of the dog? Is it like trying to get away, or is it okay?
It is trying to bite you, and it's shaking horribly the entire.
All right, I'm gonna take it. I'm gonna give it to Iris whenever I get a chance.
She is gonna scream.
What? Why? It's because it's sick and she's a healer.
I feel like Iris has definitely seen this dog before, given its established backstory.
Yeah.
Yes, it has a very rich backstory now. It's had rabies 3 times, given Nick it twice.
Actually,
Can't die.
Can you roll? Call me an animal handling.
Yes, I can.
Yeah. Okay. It only tries to bite you if you touch or try to pet it. Other than that, it seems to enjoy its added height.
Like, I understand this.
Like, Quinn, every time you look over at it, you're pretty sure the dog is enjoying looking down at you.
How big is it?
I flip it off.
It's not a big dog. Okay. It's like a terrier size.
Oh, I love it. I love him.
Okay.
He's my precious baby.
So what's he gonna name the fucker? We call it Old Mange.
Okay, so if you notice, I think the dog is blind in one eye.
Yeah, he's definitely blind in that eye.
So I'm gonna call him One Eye Mange.
God, you need an eye patch.
No.
I'm putting an eye patch on him.
It only has 3 legs. It's gonna have a peg leg too.
Yes.
Yeah, okay, sure. It's missing a leg just like you.
This is only getting better.
That's a word for what's happening.
I want to remind you that there is still, because of an old or a joke previously, there is a temple cat called Old.
Old what?
Old Grumpf.
Old Grumpf and Old Mane. The ideal combo. They're gonna murder each other.
No, they're not. They can't do that to each other. Look at them.
You're right, they're both immortal.
look at them. Like, look at that dog. Do you think it's gonna murder anything?
I mean, it tried real hard with Nick.
To be fair, everything tries to murder Nick.
That's true.
Yeah, he's eminently punchable.
All right.
Was there anything you guys wanted to do while you were out?
No, that was
nope.
It.
Just pay my mom some money.
We had to go get food because food is a thing.
Yep, we go to get food.
Yes. But before you guys go back to dinner, let's switch over to Kira.
Mm-hmm.
So Maurice comes into the room with like his cowbell that he starts ringing, but it very quickly dies around. And he's like, where is everybody?
Like, look around. She's reading the book for the book club, whatever it was called. I don't know where everyone is.
Well, dinner's ready. I'll check the training room, see if anyone's there.
Look, that's the plan.
I'll meet you there in just a minute.
Alright.
So I'm assuming you go to the to the dining room.
Yes. Yeah,
After a couple minutes, Maurice comes back and he's like scratching the back of his head. He's like, "Well, I really don't know where everybody is. I figure we might as well get started eating before Nadine and Quinn come in and eat it."
You mean it's just the two of us then?
Yeah, I suppose so. I made way too much food for that, but yeah, let me go ahead and get you some. And he starts plating the food, which is going to be what I made today. The honey chicken stuff.
Honey chicken stuff, yeah.
Yes. I'm sorry, do you want me to list off that crazy ass name?
No, you don't have to do it.
That's what I thought. So he goes ahead and he gets you a plate and he sits down. He actually sits next to you because it seems silly to sit so far away when it's just you two.
Okay. Yeah, so she like leans over to him.
Mm-hmm.
I think you have a secret.
Yeah, bitch.
Huh?
Yeah, in the future.
He looks very confused at you. I'm sorry, miss. I don't really know what you're talking about.
What? Let's find that wall.
Behind what wall?
She looks at him like
cure wishes.
like bitch, you know what I'm talking about. Yeah, behind the curtain.
Tapestry.
Or the tapestry. Yeah. Sorry, I
it's fine.
Oh,
you're always sneaking off.
I'm not always sneaking off, I have a lot of stuff to do. And he, like, immediately starts, like, shoveling food into his mouth.
I get close to him.
He's, like, leaning a little bit a ways, clearly nervous.
You're lying.
Max. Something.
No. No, there ain't.
You're too cute to lie. I know, that was the worst line I've ever said.
I can think of a few that worse.
What was what? That about? Oh, I hear you. I'm coming.
Alan wasn't like
getting up.
No, this is a good time for Quinn and Nathaniel.
Kick open the door.
With Kira Lee leaning right over him.
Very close to him, yeah.
Kick open the door. Look at her. Look at him. Look at her. Look at him. You fuck him yet?
What?
What? What? Oh, Anadine, you need some help. And he gets up and he goes over to help you with the...
No, hey, no, can you no, heal no. the mange dog?
He's like, oh my god, you found another rat.
What is that?
Is this one alive?
I oh am god, the...
God. Is it going to be shooting vines out of its mouth?
I'm gonna look at everybody very, very angrily. You stop talking about one-eyed mange like that, or I'll kill all of you.
I didn't say jack shit, dude.
What the I'll hell is you, that?
Dude. I mean, that's valid.
It's my dog.
That's a dog?
Alright, gonna slowly draw the harpoon out.
Nah, there's no kill. Or, I mean, I guess anywhere. Please don't kill an instance of sample.
Don't talk about my dog like that.
I'm sure it's a I will nice get some dog, food ready for nice your, dog. for your dog.
Hey, can you heal things?
Yeah.
Can you heal diseases or anything of the like?
Can you heal her brain?
I can heal diseases, yes. I don't know about brain stuff. I have not.
All right, old man mange. You gotta get your shots.
Oh, is it Marissa?
Oh. Hey.
Congratulations. We're getting,
hey,
we're getting
Marissa.
We're getting a dog. It's shots.
Oh, we have a dog now?
Yeah, apparently.
Yes.
We
this
have
dog
a
has an extensive
dog.
Backstory.
That's the most exciting shit I've heard all night. Fucking, what happened?
Went to a bar, got a dog.
You can get dogs at a bar?
Yes.
You pick them
apparently.
Off the street.
You know, picking up pictures, as you do.
Oh, dope. Okay, I'm sorry I'm late, but thank you for having me.
It's okay.
No problem. You were not there at the moment. Is your parents had called and they wanted to talk to you? I will shoot you a very quick message of what they wanted to talk to.
Oh, sweet. Excellent. Thank you very much.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
It was work.
Was it fun? Is work fun for you?
Oh, me? Yeah, it was whatever.
Okay. So anyways, I'm gonna pick up old man mange, and I'm gonna hold him like
his name changes every time.
Every time.
No.
No, it's either old man or one eyed. I'm gonna grab him and
okay.
I'm gonna hold him close. And I assume he's just gonna go like fucking berserk. The entire time. Alright, I got it. Don't worry about it.
We have to go through the lore for this dog.
Ooh. The dog smells food, and it's going, like, buck wild.
Alright, I'm just gonna hold the dog, though.
If you release that animal at me, I will blow it up.
I'm gonna hold dog. I'm gonna hold dog to chest.
And
I'm gonna say,
this is how Nick got rabies the second time.
Oh my god.
And now I'm gonna say, alright, Maurice, do your heel thing.
So Maurice, like, looks at this dog, looks at the fleas running across its body. And he, like, takes a deep breath to psych himself up very lightly, as delicately as possible, touches it with one waits a couple minutes, and looks back at Nadine and says, I guess technically the dog's fine.
It's not deceased at all. Like that.
All right. Who's got some spare chicken? When they look on the table, is just some chicken just sitting there?
He said he was going to get the dog some food.
All right. That's not what I asked.
Mange needs a bath.
No.
I think there's only a place for me and Maurice.
There's a bunch of food set up on the table and stuff behind it, but not on the main table.
Okay. What's the main meat?
It's chicken. It was the honey glazed.
All right, I'm gonna grab some of the honey glazed chicken. I'm gonna grab some of the honey glazed chicken, and I'm gonna put it in his gullet, and I'm gonna say, all right, I'm gonna go wash my dog now.
Give me a dex save, real quick.
Oh, don't worry about it.
That meal sounds fucking delicious.
It was pretty good.
Oh, it's adorable. He's a fighter.
He basically noms on your fingers for a second.
He's adorable.
But he does not stop shaking. He's just constantly trying to go crazy at the food.
I'm glad I'm in the other room.
I'm gonna go take him to get a bath.
Okay. It was nice playing with Nadinia.
I'm gonna also probably take said bath because I probably haven't had one since this all started, honestly.
Oh, I should bathe this dog. Looks itself.
Probably me too.
One of my friends likes to take baths with her snake because the snake likes the hot steam.
Mm-hmm.
Uh huh.
So I just do it with him.
Like, she just puts her in the water?
Or no, it's like a shower. No, like in the shower with them.
Huh. Interesting fact.
Tiffany, by the way, Marissa.
Is it really?
Yeah.
I can see that wholeheartedly. I support her life decisions.
All right. Take my dog.
Anyway. Go wash the dog.
Yay.
Iris, you roll
another one of these.
Iris, you are coming back from talking to your parents. It wasn't a long talk. They said that they would talk with you more about it.
Okay, we're in the temple yet?
Yeah. People are getting ready for dinner or eating dinner right now.
Okay, cool. Yeah, I feel like she just come in and just look very tired emotionally and physically.
Mm-hmm.
Welcome back, Iris.
Oh fuck, I forgot what my fucking accent was for a second. Shit, okay, hold on.
British.
Fuck this.
Hello. How are you all?
We're good. Nadine, you brought home old Mange.
I kind of glare at Maurice. Everything's fine.
Okay.
Is it the sexy glare, or is it?
It is not the sexy glare.
Okay, by the tone of your voice, it doesn't sound fine. Who let her bring old Mange? Was it back here? What did I mean?
I did. You remember that dog that bit Nick outside that bar?
Oh my god! I thought that thing died.
I'm glad you picked up on the goof.
Well, at least it has a good home, I guess.
At least it's not your room.
Yeah, that's what I was saying earlier. I was like, I'm not in that room.
I have the upper bunk, you can't get up there.
You don't know that.
I'm gonna kick it off the bed.
You do, I kill you.
That's his bed now. That's his bed now. And Maple, are you, after that whole encounter,
mm-hmm.
what does Maple do?
Is it like, I know this is, like, super paranoid, but she's being super paranoid right now. Is it, like, the exact same type of flower in the exact same, like, condition and everything as the one she got?
I would say, I mean, condition-wise, it looks, like, perfectly fresh.
Mm.
Like, he had just gotten it from a florist, like, minutes ago.
Mm-hmm.
In terms of looking exactly like it, it's a similar type, but, like, most florists would use this type. It's not, that's not super suspicious.
How close am I to the druid's place?
The druid's in the lower reach. You are still in the upper.
Okay. I'm being fucking so paranoid right now.
No, that's fair.
Yeah, she's gonna go back to the temple.
Okay. You return, let's just, for, you know, everyone's sake, it's right around this time when Iris just gets there, and Adenia went to go wash the dog.
Sick Sala, yeah.
So dinner's ready, if you are ready for that.
Oh, I am inhaling food.
So I repeat that there, Marissa.
No, you're good. Go ahead.
Someone else was saying something.
I didn't hear either what the fuck they said.
Yeah, both Alex and Marissa said something at the same time.
Quinn is inhaling food.
Okay. By the way, Maurice grabs his plate, shovels down the food real quick, and then says he's gonna go hunt down Val.
Mm-hmm.
And he leaves.
Glaring at him the entire time in the room.
Yeah, he keeps, like, glancing over at you and then getting very clearly flustered.
What's his mood right now? Like, seeing that, she's like, wait, what the fuck?
His mood is definitely very anxious and worried.
And I'm suspicious if you read that.
Yeah. Are you good? Looking at Maurice. Before he leaves.
Yeah, I am. I am. Okie dokie. I am good. Oh, I think I hear Val. I'll be right back. And he heads out.
No, like, she just pokes her head out to the hall. It's like, you know, you can't lie to me about your mood, but okay.
I'm sorry, Maple, I can't hear you. I'm already down the hall.
That
man's full of bullshit.
Yeah, why was he so worried?
He's hiding something. And he almost got to the bottom of it. Glare sent Nadine and Quinn.
Nadine is
gone, so you just...
Sorry, what do you think he's hiding? What exactly happened?
I think there's something hidden in the wall of the sanctuary. I couldn't get it open.
Oh. Where?
Oh, well, while he's gone. Let's go check it out.
Oh, you don't have to do that. It's fine. Don't worry about it. This is great, chick.
Maple just kind of...
Alright, here we go!
Maple casually throws the rose into, like, her drinking water and gets up and follows them.
Oh, no! Did you just throw a fucking flower Maple, in your water?
What the like hell? The stem!
I...
Like a vase.
Yes, like a very small, sad vase.
Come on.
Do you know anything about this?
We're gonna go look at the door. Come on, Iris.
I mean, do I know something? Yes. can I tell you? Probably not. But it's really fine. It's a good thing, you know, like surprises, like for your birthday. It's that sort of thing. It's just trust Maurice and trust
me. I bet between the three of us, we can just carry her.
Don't you dare!
I'll pick her up.
Oh, she makes a good point. Maybe
throw her over shoulder.
What do I roll?
That would be athletics versus acrobatics or athletics. So, Alex rolls athletics, you roll acrobatics. Ah. Okay. Alex?
Sorry, I have to actually pull up my character sheet, apparently.
I hope I'm you so sorry. One. Oh, no.
You, Iris, I've been doing this to you since we were, like, 8.
And it's not fair. Put me down right now. This is awful. She's like kicking and squirming.
All right. So you guys head over to the sanctuary. And you pull back the tapestry and you see, as I said before, a very large door that goes very, very high up, like about 20 feet.
Right.
Made out of solid wood that is incredibly heavy.
Huh.
The fucking big door.
Yes, the door is not locked, but it is just incredibly heavy.
I wonder if we could burn it.
If no. You set fire to this temple, I swear to Isis, I will kill you.
You realize that the door is behind the tapestry, right? And you could burn the tapestry.
It was a fucking joke. Y'all are no fun.
Look, if anyone's going to burn anything, it's me. And I'm going to burn anything here.
Yeah, because your track record with burning has been so fucking great.
I'm gonna... Regardless, Quinn, can you put me down, please? I don't like being elevated. It makes me uncomfortable.
I'm gonna put my ear against the door.
I'll put her down.
Any movement inside? Can I hear anything?
No, it's very big and solid.
So how do we open the door?
Well, I could try pushing it open.
Well, it's actually Iris who actually goes through the door.
Oh, me go through the door, you say? Doors are such funny things, don't you?
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Somehow you've gotten worse at lying.
I never lie.
What color does she turn when she's lying? Is it purple?
Let me find my cheat sheet.
Marissa, I did send you how you open up the door.
Probably. You literally change shades when you lie.
She's orange when she's nervous, so probably that. So she's like very fucking traffic cone.
Cone. Traffic cone. Nice.
I mean, look, even if hypothetically I did know maybe how to open it, we shouldn't really go poking around. We can just wait until the time is right and it will be fine.
Eyebrow raise.
I mean, do you trust me?
Yes, but you know it's more fun when we do things my way.
That has never been the case. Do you remember that one Wednesday we all agreed never happened? That was awful, and that was your idea.
I don't remember. We agreed it never happened.
Why are you bringing it up? God.
I don't know what you're talking about. And he's just smirking like he clearly knows what you're talking about.
Mabel just kind of sighs, seeming to give up, and goes, well, anyways, I think I met Cypress tonight, and, like, walks back to the dining hall.
Iris fucking grabs your hand and stops you and is like, I'm sorry, you what?
Well, I went for a jog, and there was some really good music, so I stopped and looked, and it was crowded, so I jumped on the building. It was just some elf guy. playing a pan flute. The thing that we found in the place, right? And he noticed me and then changed his music, and then I felt the charm effect. But I'm pretty good at shaking those off, so I was fine, and then he was gone, and then there was a rose at my foot. So.
So you got hit on by a street bard.
Yeah.
Oh my god, are you alright? Oh, that sounds horrifying.
Kind of shrugged.
To be hit on by a street bard.
Horrifying.
Yes!
I mean, have you met street bards?
She just kind of shrugs and goes, he's not my type.
They have more diseases than one I meet.
Probably.
Right.
The only bad thing is that I didn't get to see his entire face. So.
And what makes you think it's this Cypress fellow?
He charmed literally everyone around him and was playing the pan flute.
That is a pretty standard MO for Cypress.
I mean, it's the first bard I've seen here ever.
But, yes, I used poor words. What I meant is, yes, that's the description. I'm sorry, that's an Alex brain being stupid.
No, it's okay.
There were bards at the festival, but generally speaking, there's not a whole lot.
How common is anti-bard sentiment?
Constant. Not necessarily anti-bard, just if you're in the lower reach, you can't afford to give money for entertainment. So right. They're not super common, and in the upper reach, they're really only invited for performances at parties and stuff. Not as many just like on the street corners and stuff.
I think Maple kind of freezes for a second, seeming to have like a sudden realization and kind of goes pale.
What is it, Maple?
Nope. Nothing that we probably have to worry about. Maybe.
No.
That is the most bizarrely ominous statement you've made this evening. So,
Iris,
like,
who is a five out of shit. Iris, like, squeezes your hand and is like, no, please tell us. What is it?
Her ears turn a bit red. I mean, it's not something I really want to talk about until something happens, so.
What does that mean?
That's also about a 5 out of 10.
You know, Dinner's getting cold.
Okay, how about this?
Yeah,
how
Maurice about... and Iris.
I mean, look, okay, how about this? How about
y'all are a bunch of flighty fucks. I'm gonna go eat.
Okay. I mean, I don't want to do this, but if I give you a hint about the doll, would you maybe want to tell us? I don't want to pry, but this could really help us, you know, save the children.
Could it?
I don't really think it has anything to do with the children, a more personal thing.
Well, give us a hint anyway.
I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to pry. I just, sorry. It's been a day.
No, it's fine. Yeah.
All right. Well, let's stop harassing our good friends of the temple, and let's go back to dinner then.
First of all, I've never stopped harassing anyone in my life. But yes, dinner's getting cold.
Ugh.
Okay. You guys go back to dinner. Nadidi, I'm assuming you finish up your shower and join them.
Do you bring the dog? Okay.
You also have a Collectious.
Collectious?
Collections.
Collectious.
collection.
I have a collection
of scratches from the dog.
I look like I've been through a fucking war. But is bathed.
Yeah, I mean, the dog looks cleaner than the horrible creature.
Mabel sees you walk in with this rat-looking thing, and she, like, opens her mouth to make a comment, and then stops, and then just closes her mouth again and goes back to eating.
I feel like Mabel living on the streets would have killed something similar to that.
100%. 100%. Just to put it out of its misery, yeah.
I love it. I love it. I love it, and I love him.
Mabel was going to say, I thought you hate rats, but then she realized that no one else knows and said nothing.
Like, oh wait, that would be
Mabel is the only one with Mabel is the only one with self-awareness and self-preservation.
I mean, Iris.
I mean, I fucking like poked at her as soon as I saw it, so. Because I
she just knows giving that ammo to the other two would be bad. And yes,
also your spine being broken would be bad, so
if you could catch me.
I could throw my harpoon pretty fucking hard. I
play all you gotta do is take my glasses.
I can catch that.
Quinn doesn't pick on Nadinia usually.
I don't usually pick on her either.
Yeah.
It's only me. I'm the only one that picks on people. Normally.
No, anyway. Quinn made fun of Mabel for the crush.
Yeah.
I said normally.
I'm trying to be supportive.
Quinn laughed at her and she fucking punched him in the back.
Yeah, that's fair. Totally. Fair.
Anyways, I come in and I say, Iris, can you do me a favor?
That depends entirely on what it is.
Can you even make sure that the dog is in good health? I promise he'll behave. Is he's like probably
that animal handling?
He's probably shaking in pure unbridled rage. Pure unbridled.
Oh no!
Currently eating your arm.
Are you sure that's a dog?
As he...
Nadinia, I'm not sure about its health, but it doesn't very much seem to like you at all.
Oh no, he loves me.
There is blood just coming, like, pouring out of your arm.
Maybe you should put him down and let him run around outside for his exercise.
Alright, we're gonna go to the boat.
Okay.
By the way, I named the boat the butt.
Excuse me? For real?
Yeah, that did happen.
But why?
Because it's a pretty big butt.
Are you serious?
Because Chris and Alex are like 8 years old.
Together.
So, hey, Alicia.
We're combined 8 years old.
You like all that extra prep you did tonight? Just in case?
Yeah. Yeah, you're going to get to like... I'm hoping you guys are going to get to the mission.
Yeah, I'm going to say... I'm going to go to bed.
No, it's great.
It's your fault great. At all.
It's so much better than Nathaniel's stupid...
Hey, fucking man, Jesus Christ.
I'm gonna, when she leaves, she's gonna take the rose with her to the room.
Okay.
I'm gonna come back a few moments later and I'm gonna be like, can somebody fix my arm?
Oh, yeah, sure, come here.
I hold it up and the dog's probably just hanging from it. Yeah. I need to get a peg leg for him.
Yeah, he's also three-legged.
Oh my god, really?
This is a three-legged, one-eyed abomination.
Someone needs to draw
Did
this.
Did you see the picture? Well, I put the
picture. Oh, is there a picture?
Yeah, just scroll up a little bit.
I think Alicia Googled ugly dog and just put that in.
And yeah.
I don't know, my God.
This is a character in her game now.
I kind of love it.
Right? That's what I said.
Anyway, so they, Maurice recommended that you guys get there at around 8 or so. That's when, the actual guards are going to be switching with you.
Mm-hmm.
And you'll be working it until the right people steal it. Then you're free to go home because there's nothing else in there.
But if the wrong people steal it or try to poison it, if I recall, was their her job?
Yep. That was what the government did a long time ago. So essentially what this mission was is Raymond had a bunch brought in because of the food shortages. However, in the past, when the government did this, there were accounts of supposed poison.
I mean, so poison works.
Poison and disease. basically tainted supplies that they were handing out to people.
Mm-hmm.
So they don't trust the government for handouts. So Raymond basically is trying to get the Red Rioters to steal it. That way people will be willing to use it.
Mm. Okay.
So it's your guys' job to be really, really shitty guards.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. And let me... I'm assuming you guys just have dinner and then head down there when it gets close to time.
Mm.
Yeah.
All right. Let me throw you on the
finally
map.
Finally eat that chicken.
After going to investigate a door.
It's a really good door, that's all I'm saying.
God.
Wait, Shut can up. I go through the door whenever I want?
Yeah, you
Fuck know yeah. how.
I hate we're you. Down by the docks?
Yes. Pretend that that's not water and it's sky.
Okay. Sky!
I think immediately Mabel would just take position on top of the roof if she could get there.
Yeah, yep, that's no problem at all for down here. You don't have to make any kind of check for that.
Feature on the map.
Yeah, you guys can put yourselves on. These right here are doors, and then there are two windows right here.
I am going to wait for the guards that are being replaced by us, and then I'm going to loudly announce that I'm going to go take a nap.
Okay. You loudly announce this. You wait till they leave, or do you do it while they're still there?
I just said I wait till they
leave. I'm sorry! I realized after I asked it, I was like, no wait, you said that they left. Okay. But you guys are free to position yourselves as you would. Remember, you want to be terror.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm on the roof.
Okay. So you are probably basically unseen right now. Mm-hmm. Iris, are you hanging out?
Am I what? Sorry, you cut out.
Are you hanging out by the window?
Oh, yes. That's a window? Hell yeah. Sure.
Yeah, this is the door. These are doors, and the small ones are windows.
I'm daydreaming out a window.
Okay.
Wistfully.
You mean night dreaming?
Exactly. I'm wishing I'm a shooting star.
Not just
I'm acting like I'm watching the sky.
Okay. And
gotta watch out for sky pirates.
So, me. You have to watch out for me. I'm gonna go over to Kira. So, did you fuck him?
No.
Why not?
You have no sense of decorum, do you?
No, I have sense of decorum. I just choose to ignore it. Why not?
Well, no. That's just not the kind of person I am. And I don't think it's the kind of person he is.
Well, why don't you just, like... What is it that you're supposed to do? Date him?
I don't think he knows what's going on. Or perhaps he doesn't care.
I could go find out for you.
Why are you so interested?
Because if you don't take him, I'm gonna fuck him.
Oh! I wasn't expecting it!
Ooh,
I'm sorry!
Get him!
What did she say?
Because I like seeing a good romance story.
I like them picture shows.
I write fan fiction.
And
you've already written my fanfic.
Between you and Maple, it's kind of terrible.
I don't think Nadine knows about it, does she?
I didn't think so.
Yeah.
I can't think of anywhere that she'd know. But
okay, well, you're terrible.
Thanks. You're so kind.
No, I'm not.
Congratulations.
Anyways, are you going to tell him or no?
Sure, maybe.
Don't wait too long. He's one of those dumb types. They don't catch on very easily. And like, apparently a lot of people like that kind. I think it's stupid.
Chris, you asshole.
I'm not into that, you know. I like mine.
Even
I don't know.
Dumber.
I like mine small and cute.
Is that what you're into then?
As you're saying that, funny enough, you see
oh, no!
Holding up. Oh god, my card ended up tiny.
Tiny card.
It's tiny and cute.
I know.
Oh my god.
That was
who
it.
Else?
That was...
Who else put the
but you see two people sitting on the as it starts to well it actually stops right there and you watch as a couple people get off clearly it's pretty easily visible but you can tell that they're trying to hide it.
Oh, no.
As you watch oh shit, I didn't make him a token. Fuck.
Put him up in this all pink glory. There you go.
Yeah. As he hops off. And you see a couple more people still in there. He hops off with this girl. And you see...
Hey, it's Piper.
I know, I was surprised at how much it looks like Piper.
Oh god, that guy's such a shitbag. I love it.
As you see these two, actually these three stay in.
Ooh.
Who's that hottie?
She's pretty.
Roll a perception real quick. Kira and Nadinia.
I will perceive.
Okay.
per yes.
Lamp. Right. No, Kira, you're too engrossed in this conversation, but
it would be closer, but yeah.
Yeah. Nadinia.
It's because you wear glasses. Fucking nerd.
Yeah, there's
well, no, this is something you hear, Nadinia.
Fucking nerd.
As you hear Nick like, all right. Now, this is really important. We have the plan. The plan. Oh wait, shit. Everyone take off the arm sleeves for the Red Rioters. You gotta take those off.
Now just taking them off. Jesus fucking Christ, dude.
Why is he the most effective Red Rioter now that I'm gone?
Why is he the agent in charge?
He was your right hand man. Of course everyone's gonna think he's good enough.
As I'm like saying, I like him small and cute, and then I hear his voice, and I go, speaking of which.
No, don't flirt. We can't let them know we know you're here.
He's like, all right, we got this. We can do this. They finally trusted us. All right, ready, everyone, team. And he was like, puts in his hand, and the girls put their hands in, and the asshole does not. And he's like, all right, get enough. Go.
And we're literally just staring at them.
Yes.
I'm pretty sure Maple's just on the roof looking at them and just, like, pinches the bridge of her nose.
Gonna run over to... I'm really? Running over to him.
Really? You dumb bitch?
Okay. You run straight up to him and he's like, Nadinia!
I'm gonna grab him and pull him into a hug. Nick, hi, I missed you.
I look in horror.
He literally jumps a bit when you hug him, and you can see his tail's like wagging back and forth like a dog.
Oh my god,
no. Dumbass bitch!
And he's like, hi. What's up?
I got a dog. He reminds me a lot about you, except he's far more aggressive.
Maple just starts fucking losing her goddamn mind at that. So she's this is the on worst the roof, one. Fucking rolling around.
Quinn almost actually passes out at the horror of this concept.
I am standing agape, like.
And he turns to the car and don't run over my foot again. You guys.
Did they run over your foot? Do you want me to hurt them for you?
No, I told him who was boss. And he like very noticeably like winks at them. And they keep going.
I need to get Nadinia away from. So I'm gonna like throw a rock, like a small pebble at her head.
Okay, roll me just do an unarmed strike.
Clonk.
Hey.
I pretend not to notice. So Nick, what has you out here tonight?
I found some assholes for you to beat up.
What? Wait.
Are you calling about this? Are you just yelling from on top of the roof?
No, I'm just yelling from on top of the roof because she started laughing anyways.
Okay.
She points to the other side of the fucking building and like they're like, fuckers are over here, and like just walks across the roof out of sight.
I look at Nick. Okay, so here's the thing, Nick. I thought about it. And I think we should go on a date.
You watch him completely freeze, just unprocessing.
He dies. He just dies.
And he's... I'm sorry, what? What did you say?
Tomorrow at 8. Okay, bye.
What did you just...
Wait, is that AM or PM? Wait, what is it? Where am I supposed to meet you? I can't. I don't have your number.
go over to Kira and look at, look, like, pointedly look at her and say, and that's how you do it.
Hi, Romance.
As that's going, this cart approaches you, Kira, as the one asshole in orange, the orange tiefling, looks over to you, and he says, we're here to...
We're here to what?
Pick up.
Do you have papers?
Wow. Wow. You know, that's
you're
being
like
a good
T-balling
guard.
This to him, and they're like, hmm.
That's being a good guard. Bad guard would have been like, oh yeah, sure.
I don't know. I feel like fake papers is a minimum logical thing to have.
She's acting.
The orange guy very noticeably turns back to Nick and shrugs.
I pretend not to notice.
As the one girl next to him is like, you know, I am so sorry. I think we left that in our cart.
Oh, well, I can just get you a form if you need.
Yes, that would be lovely.
Okay.
But she's so bad.
What?
No, I'm listening to the people from the roof. Maple's like listening to this and just being like, oh my god, they're so bad.
Okay. And like, I basically just walk away from my post. It's like,
yeah.
Like, I'm going somewhere, but I'm not.
Did you see the bad guys that were supposed to be over here?
No, just keep looking.
As that's going, the girl finally gets Nick to kind of snap out of it, and they start making their way along the side, kind of like peeking into the windows, and when they get here, they both peek in, and you audibly hear Nick go, Iris?
Oh my god, Nick, is that you?
Oh
you
my god.
Say hi.
This is a disaster.
Oh my, it has been so long. How are you?
Also, that door is completely unguarded now.
Yeah, though.
Quinn is like doing the really loud fake snore. He snores like I do.
Mm-hmm.
Except he's awake.
So as it's unguarded, this one comes in. And Nick, you actually... Or not Nick. Quinn, you actually recognize all of them. They are all part of your old Red Rider group.
So is this like the D team?
I think this might be like, what? And that's the worst part.
They might be the F team.
Yeah.
No, they're the A team. They're the
these
A
are
team.
These are basically the worst team possible.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
They are your A team. Good fucking luck.
So there's a small brief argument between the orange tiefling and the one girl as he sighs and like hops down and like shuffles in muttering under his breath. And they kind of stop when they see you, Quinn, for a sec. And you hear a brief conversation where the one girl who you know's name is she's talking to the one tiefling, and she's like she's like, oh, it's Quinn, maybe he can help him. And the guy's like, nah, he's part of the upper reach now. There's no hope for him.
Yikes.
He's
sore
a
bladder.
Damn.
Ouch.
And they each struggle to lift one of the cart or one of the boxes as they like start trying to load them out.
Man, I'd love to help them if they weren't fucking assholes. Snore.
Wow.
The one so girl funny. Jumps out and she's like at the door, like, hey, he's coming. He's coming back over here. And the tiefling like just drops it. The Aragonasi doesn't make it, so she dives in and hides.
How many did they get? One?
Zero.
They got two. Oh no, they got one. I'm sorry. I'm gonna put these over here because they keep going under the cart. So okay. They got one.
I'm gonna start walking back, and then did I catch any of them, like carrying anything?
You definitely saw the Cloud Ganassi like dive into the
box
pile.
I'm gonna walk in. I'm gonna be like
coming after it.
No.
I look over at Kira. What? You told me that they needed help help loading things. I'm going to go help them load things.
Who told you that?
Bitch, you're really bad at playing along, aren't you?
And I'm going to say, where did you guys need these boxes?
In the cart. Great.
Which one of them was the one I asked for papers? It was the tiefling, right?
It was this one. Okay. Well, you asked the tiefling. She's the one that kind of finished talking.
Okay, so I walk up to her and I say, well, we don't have any of the requisite forms on hand, so I'm going to have to go up to the administrator's office and go get some. So.
Oh, that is, I'm so sorry about the inconvenience with that. How far away is that, and how long will it take you to get there and back, and approximately how long do you think you're going to be there?
It's going to take a while.
Oh, okay.
I'm sorry, yeah, we can't leave until then, but you can start loading. I'm sure it's fine.
Yeah, thank you so much. Yeah, that's great.
Medina comes out with one of the boxes. Where do you need this box?
In the cart.
I load it into the cart.
I really hope you can do this in 20 minutes, because for fuck's sake.
Maple is actually keeping lookout for anyone else on top of the roof, just in case.
Yeah. Nick is greeting Iris. He's like, when did you get back in town? He's like, I haven't heard from you in forever.
Oh my god, that's because Quinn never gave you any of the letters I wrote. That's totally his bad. I got back like a day ago.
God.
Oh yeah.
Except...
directly under the bus.
He did read the letters to Nick.
The one girl behind Nick like taps him on the shoulder. She's like, Nick, we're on a mission. We can't do this right now. We're on a mission.
How loud are they, by the way?
Pretty fucking loud.
Too loud.
Nick, very loud.
All right, so Nadinia hears Nick and says, I will be right back, as she drops off another box.
Okay.
Oh my god.
Sorry, did you say you needed permission? Do you need a permission form? I can go grab one for you.
Open the door.
God.
Look outside, see them two talking.
I am going to die. Uh-huh. This is going to kill me. Eternal bleeding will kill me.
Maple's literally on the roof going, oh my fucking god.
Like, we keep setting it up for each other, and it doesn't work because we're all trying to do the same, do different things.
I look outside, and I look at Iris, and look at Nick, and look at Iris, and look at Nick. What's going on out here?
Oh no.
Oh, I think they need a form. Didn't Kira, we should go with her to go get these nice people forms so they could load their stuff.
Do you know Nick?
Of course I do.
How do you know Nick?
Yeah, why? take a walk.
Don't be a stupid bitch.
Jesus Christ.
Ladies.
I'm going to murder all of you. Snore.
Just hear a soft padding from, like, up top of the roof as, like, Mabel has Brissy to start smacking herself in the forehead with her stick.
Hard enough to forget, but the not hard enough for permanent damage.
Yep.
This is working.
Ladies, ladies, ladies. Listen, there's enough Nick to go around.
I'm going to vomit.
But Iris is she's an old friend. Used to be the three of us, me, her, and Quinn.
I knew you were Quinn's friend. I didn't know you had others.
It's not like that.
She's gonna turn around and just grab a box very like aggressively and start moving it to the cart.
Oh my!
No, God. Wait! No, it's not like that, Nadinia. Nadinia. Nadinia, I'm so sorry. And he looks into the pot. He's like, Nimmy, are you stuck?
When Nick tries to walk past Quinn, he's gonna like snore loudly and roll off the cart in front of him.
Oh my god, Quinn! Oh, are you all here?
Yeah, shut up. I'm trying to sleep.
Go back inside.
Can you please
see this box over here? Grab it. Take it back.
Can you please tell Nadinia that I'm not.
Yeah, tell her you're gay.
What? Wait, what? What did you say you're gonna tell her?
So you're gay.
We had this discussion. I said no homo each time.
Oh, so you dated both of them, Quinn?
Oh my god.
I come back in to hear that. Excuse you?
Huh? What?
So, you and Quinn...
What? No! No, 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 no.
Disgusting.
No, I mean... I needed cash. It was not Quinn. I needed cash and Quinn's fucking broke as hell.
I'm actually not. He starts counting his money.
At the time.
He just starts counting.
Listen, it only happened like twice, and I said no homo, so it doesn't.
Jesus fucking Christ.
How long has it been since they started this, by the way?
Too long.
It's probably been about 20 minutes.
Okay, Maple's jumping off the roof, like onto the cart.
Okay.
Just jumps down onto the cart and looks at them too, and just goes, "It's been 20 minutes."
They both scream.
Ninja.
The girl falls off the cart. The guy pulls out a very rusty-looking dagger.
I'm going to push Nick out of the way, but. It's not into the wall, it's more like I like bumped into him very aggressively.
If you pushed him into the wall, he
see, yeah, that's this is why I have to be very, very direct with him, because he'll just take it the wrong way. And I'm going to pointedly say, "Oops, I didn't see you there."
Oh my fucking god.
Come on, you had to see me. I'm blue. Nadinia.
Baby.
I can't believe you fucked it up before it even began.
I finally got a date with a girl and I somehow ruined it.
There should only be one box left.
Yes. There's been a couple trips.
Yeah, Mabel just lands on the thing and just goes, "It's been 20 minutes.
The guy in orange, like I said, he's brandishing his rusty dagger and he says, "Who are you? Who are you working for? Is it the government? Huh? Huh? Is it the leeches up there?"
You know that's not gonna fucking cut anyone, right?
Psh, I think he's like, He's like, you don't know what I can do. You don't know what I'm capable of.
I whack him on the head with my stick.
Yeah, go ahead and roll that.
He just falls over, just unconscious. It does no roll. Nothing.
Yeah, I'm more so I want the damage. Or are you just knocking him out?
I'm not knocking him out. I'm just kind of whacking him a bit. So I'm kind of holding back.
She's doing the teacher.
Yeah.
Slap on the top of the head. The Lord of the Rings where Gandalf like hits the hobbits with the fucking stick.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You whack him on the head. And he starts like wildly swinging the dagger. He's not actually within range. He's just kind of like swinging it around because you're up on the top of the boxes.
Yeah,
and he's just like, he's got like his eyes closed as he's doing it.
Grab the last box and I'm carrying it out.
Okay, tip one, number one, open your fucking eyes, you moron. Tip number two, you have a dagger, get within range.
He's like, I don't need tips from you.
As he, like, does the thing she's telling him
tip
to
number
do.
Three. Yeah, as he's doing it. Tip number three, if you try to fight anyone in that condition, you're gonna die.
He's like, then I'll die for a just cause.
No, you'll die being an idiot.
As he tries to, like, climb up the boxes, keeps not being able to. And he's like, get down here.
Nah. And as Nadine is like loading the last box, she just looks at him and goes, and the next time you try to do a heist, don't leave one of your companions in the fucking building. And then she just climbs back up onto the roof.
Okay.
Oh my god.
Well, you're all loaded.
Yes. We are all loaded.
I'm sure my partner will come back with the requisition form at any time. You stay here. I'm going to go back inside and make sure that everything is accounted for.
Nadinia, please.
I'm gonna go back inside. I'm gonna walk up. I'm gonna walk over to Nick and I'm gonna say, I think it's time. Your friends are outside waiting for you.
Your other friends.
Quinn, do you run over to help Nimmy?
Nimmy, are you stuck under a box again?
Yes.
Okay. I'll move the box. I know you're like made out of clouds, but you really need to lift some weights.
Thanks. And the two of you managed to get her out. And as they're leaving, she kind of pats you on the shoulder and she says, I knew you weren't a leech. Heads out.
I hope it
damn
takes...
fucking right.
I really hope what I did takes that guy's ego down like a peg or two.
He's probably definitely not. Sulking.
Mm-hmm.
Probably not, honestly. Do you see him?
Long term, no, but...
Yeah, short term.
He's trying to do, like, you ever have, like, those edgy kids in class that, like, play with knives, and
yes.
You're like, God, he looks so
yes.
fucking stupid.
Yeah.
He's doing that with the dad, and he's just
he's
mumbling under his breath.
No, he's got, like, a butterfly knife, but...
he's like,
and he's like the spy from Team Fortress. He's like flipping the knife and he stabs himself. Oh, fuck.
He's like, oh, this is... she didn't have the high ground. I mean, she got an opportunity attack. Like, she was surprised. Uh-huh. It was fine. I was protecting her.
Wasn't fair. Nobody could have fought that person.
He just hears that. Uh-huh, yeah,
like
sure, bud.
Iris, after Nick left, you were left with this one girl who, and she like looks at you for a second and she like looks around realizing that Nick left her and she's like, oh no. And she pulls out like a big wizard book and she like goes through it real quick. She's like, there, and she casts a spell and turns invisible.
magic!
Oh no! Magic!
What shall I do? Oh no! And she just fucking like goes back inside very slowly and calmly.
When she casts it, she starts horribly sneezing.
It's like something over her.
And Quinn, you know that this girl, who is indeed a wizard, the reason why she's part of your group is she's actually allergic to magic.
Oh no.
She's allergic to what?
Magic.
To magic.
She sneeze.
Sneezer. What's her name?
Depending on the level of magic, it gets worse.
Her name's Piper.
Honestly, I'm just gonna call her Piper because I will accidentally call her Piper. So it is Piper, and she's just, you hear her like invisible sneezing and as she's like running away.
Oh no.
Alright, so yeah, I'm gonna go, I'm gonna let Nick go, and I'm doing like the hot, so this is like one of the few times the Dean is acting a little bit like pride noble, and she's like huffing like a, like the proper noblewoman, you know.
Yeah, I do it all the time.
Yeah, you're Kira right now.
You're a leech.
And, going to go over to Iris.
Is our date still on? I still don't know the time or place.
Nick, just fucking leave, dude.
Oh, right. Shit, I'm on a mission. I mean, I'm helping on my new job with collecting boxes.
Oh my god.
Can you please talk to her and tell her that I'm not gay? And not. And, you know. Can you win my
job? Do your job for the Red Riders.
The what?
And yes.
No, this is a job that I'm.
Yeah, I'm a leech. Fuck you.
I don't think you're a leech. Bye. And he hops in the car, and you hear very briefly, he's like, God damn, where the fuck is Piper? And you hear very softly, here, as they all kind of climb into the very overloaded cart. They did not plan that through. And they drive off. And you guys have succeeded on your guard mission.
Yay. Maple just, like, slides down the roof and comes inside and goes, that was the most painful fucking thing I've ever done.
So, Iris.
Oh, hi. Yeah, so you're going on a date with Nick? That's delightful.
You're dead to me.
Sorry?
So, no. Did you, So you know Nick before?
Oh, yes, he and Quinn and I, we were children together. We were friends. We grew up in the Lower Reach.
Ah, so you were childhood friends.
Yes, emphasis on friends, like double underline that verbally.
Oh my god.
I see. So there's nothing that you want to tell me about Nick, or Nick should tell me about you.
I mean, I can tell you his favorite color, but no, please, God, no. He's all yours, my friend.
I bet it's blue.
It is.
It's actually pink.
Oh my god.
Oh, good. Because I was going to snap your neck in half. But now we don't have to do that.
I'm so glad to hear that. You can be very terrifying sometimes.
That's the idea.
You're gonna have to reintroduce him to Old Man Mange.
Oh, I'm taking Old Man Mange with me.
Yeah.
Speaking of which, we still need to get him a peg leg. Where would one go to get a peg leg for a dog?
Creature out of its misery.
I think you get a strap of wood and you just tie it to its leg.
That's not what happened for me. I look down at my peg leg. It's fitted to have the wooden wrap around it, around the stubble, and then it has the attachments to go to it and everything.
So clearly there's actual time and effort put into this whole thing, but you still just went with a peg leg.
Yep.
Oh, that's actually a very interesting question. Sorry if this is rude, but Nadinia, how did you lose your leg?
Probably being a pirate.
Well, no. I mean, yes, I was a pirate at the time. But, what's the name of the storm again? We don't know, right? It's just called the storm.
The one in the middle?
Yes.
It's usually just known as, the storm, hurricane, sometimes it's called the center of the world.
I took a trip to the center of the world, came back alive. It took me leg.
Yarr.
Never talk like that again. Fuck you.
Hey! It took my leg, the love of my life, my unicorn, or not my unicorn, my Pegasus.
I was like, how did you get a unicorn?
How did you get a Pegasus?
What do you mean? You go out and find one, and then you ride it.
Uh-huh.
How do you get a Pegasus?
I don't know. I wouldn't claim to have one.
Well, it was a very intelligent creature, and I loved it. Unfortunately, it died in the storm. As well as the rest of my crew, or at least I never saw them again. Anyways, back to more pleasant things.
Was the previous love as your love of your life as stupid as...
No. You will not insult the captain like that.
The captain.
I don't need to know about your king, Steve. I'm gonna walk away.
You will never insult the captain like that. Do I make myself clear?
Okay. From like half a block away.
Anyways, let's go home. Probably lock up the place. Do we have a key?
No.
This place is fucked.
There is nothing else in there of note.
Yeah.
It's all empty boxes for the rest of it.
Alright, cool. Leave the place wide open for squatters to squat.
Probably what it usually is for.
Mm-hmm. There were actually like 7 different squatters in there the whole time.
Yeah, watching this fuckfest.
What are you talking about? It was beautiful.
Alright, so you guys get back. It's probably not that late. The group was really dumb and came kind of early.
Super all right, early. So
you guys probably get back at around 11.
All right, this is super important. All I did was lock Mains in the room.
What did he
do?
I'm really glad I'm not in that room.
Yeah, really fucking glad.
Real right fucking now. Glad. Yeah, our room's best.
Well, your door is completely scratched up. Your sheets have been ripped to shreds. The pillow's been ripped to shreds. Anything that was on the floor has been ripped to shreds. It's not a house trained dog.
I look at Mange. Does as I like go into the room, does he know what he did?
He's currently chewing on a pillow. Makes eye contact with you and continues to chew on the pillow.
Alright, I'm gonna walk over to him and I'm gonna be as I'm gonna do the most aggressive no that I could possibly muster.
No.
Alright, give me animal handling.
Can I do intimidation? No.
You know that's not how that works.
Alright. Bad dog. No. No.
His cupcake looks up and says, what did I do?
He doesn't look ashamed, but he stops chewing on the pillow.
Alright, I'm gonna go give this dog a heart attack. I'll be right back, Quinn.
Okay.
It probably smells like pee and shit in there.
Okay. I just start tossing all of her stuff into the hallway because all of my stuff was like up on my bed. So it's only her stuff that's been peed and shit on.
I'm gonna take him to the magic room.
Okay.
And I'm gonna imagine me a cliff.
I'm
gonna
throw
what the fuck, my dude?
On the cliff instead of killing it.
And I'm gonna go sit on the cliffside and I'm gonna look out at it and I'm gonna say, you see all this? You see how great this all is? How wonderful it is? I could toss you over this cliff.
It's a dog. It doesn't understand you.
I'm gonna hold the dog over the cliff.
It starts really shaking.
Oh. Now you're scared. Okay. Pull the dog back. Bad dog. No. No. Do not chew my stuff. I will get you a chew toy.
It doesn't stop shaking as bad as when you were holding it over the edge.
You traumatized that dog to hate you.
Yes. Yes. Now the healing process can begin.
That's not how you train
Chris,
animals.
Chris, you work with children.
That's not how you train animals.
Nadinia is terrible at this.
No shit.
Okay.
She knows how to handle horses.
He tries to hold the horse over
her head. I doubt it.
You know all that horse.
That's about it.
The dog tries everything it can to get out of your.
Oh no, I'm not letting it go. And we're gonna go back to the room, and I'm going to set it down in the corner, and I'm going to start cleaning up. I don't care how long it takes me to clean, but I am cleaning up.
Okay. It honestly shouldn't take you too long, just dumped all your stuff outside.
Bro, what the fuck did you do to this dog?
Held it over a cliff.
God. You and Nick are perfect for.
Pray the dog hates both of you now.
Oh no, please tell me you don't hold Nick over the edge of a cliff.
That's what I'm thinking too.
No, I was just going to say you're both stupid as fuck.
No, I'm just saying.
No. Honestly,
I wouldn't put it over her.
Honestly, he'd probably like it.
I'm in danger.
It's hot though.
But anyways.
Yeah, you're right.
Anyways, cleaning up and everything.
Was there anything else anyone else wanted to do?
Well, I need to go apologize to Maurice, but you wanted to do something?
I mean, I finally found the healing potion.
Oh, yeah, that's right. The healing potion that's been sitting on your bed.
It's from Maurice.
Are the other two in the room with me when she finds it?
Iris probably would be.
Probably not, actually.
But you also find something.
Oh.
Yes, you find another rose.
Shut the fuck up right now.
There's two now on her bed because she put the other one on her bed.
Yep.
She just kind of freezes and picks up both the roses and turns to Iris and goes, "This wasn't you, right?"
No, I haven't been back in the room in a while. Oh, ow. My god, is that from
Psych? She goes super fucking pale. Goes, "Oh no.
Oh no.
Are you alright? Do you know what this is?"
Fuck. And she gets out of the room and goes and tries to find Maurice.
Okay. So both Kira and Maple are trying to find Maurice.
Kira probably finds him first. Sorry.
Kira, you find him stepping out from behind the tapestry.
Hello, Maurice.
I was checking something.
You know, I'm going to find out sooner or later what's behind that door. And I'm very curious.
That is a wonderful quality of yours, Miss Kira. But there is no door. As you can clearly see it behind him.
Look, I would just like to apologize for being so confrontational. No. I just don't like when people keep things from me.
Thank you. I'm really sorry about it. And he looks very guilty.
I'm certain you have good reasons to keep it secret, then.
We'll tell you very soon.
Okay.
We actually joined a cult.
We did, though. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I think before she says anything else, what's her face? Maple.
Mm-hmm.
What's her face?
Comes in.
Maple.
She is like white as a sheet. And is very fast walking.
Maple, y'all right?
Kira, did you put another rose in my bed?
I have not put any roses anywhere.
Then we have a problem. Here. I think I'm being stalked.
Thank you. Oh.
she, like, retells the story of what happened earlier. Mm-hmm. And how she just walked into the room and there's another fucking rose.
Any idea who this person might be?
Cypress.
Someone has a crush on you.
Or something worse.
Why would they be interested in you?
Maybe they were... Did you recognize them from the ship you were on originally?
No. But there might be someone looking for... She, like, gestures at her appearance. This.
Oh, that's right. What if you change in your appearance?
I looked like this when I was on board, and kind of like bites her lower lip pretty hard, and just someone might have recognized me.
Do you have a past with Cyprus?
No.
You ever been there?
Where?
Cyprus.
No. I've only been in Echoes my entire life.
Well, I'll let Val know, see if maybe we don't really too much security. Because this is kind of a...
temple.
Yeah, but I'll see if we can get someone to stop making some rounds. Do you think it might be good to take on a different appearance in the...
Yeah, probably.
If you don't mind, I'd like to examine the rose.
Yeah, she, like, hands both the roses over to you.
Okay, I will cast Detect Magic.
Nope, they are just normal flowers.
They're entirely mundane.
He did do a charm effect on me.
Did it take?
No.
Did it affect anyone else?
Everyone.
What happened to them?
They started swaying to the music, and when he disappeared, they went back to business like nothing happened. Like they weren't there listening to someone.
Marie seems... Repeat that.
Can I use a arcana?
They started swaying to the music.
Mm-hmm.
And then I felt the effect take over my mind for a second. I shook it off. He was no longer there. There was a rose at my foot. And everyone went about their business like nothing happened.
As it sounds like the enthrall spell to me.
Go tell Iris that.
Oh.
Like now.
Okay.
I know what it is.
That specifically. And I'll come with you. We gotta. And
okay, heads over the room. Sorry, Kira.
No, this is more important. Certainly.
When you guys get to the room, Iris, you're talking to Quinn.
Yeah, we're talking about book club. It's really great.
What book have I been handed?
I don't remember the shit. Fantasy William Faulkner, I think.
Yeah.
As I Lay Dying.
Yeah, that's it. Okay, so it's actually very interesting. Each of the chapters, I mean, one of the chapters is only a sentence. It's quite breathtaking.
Uh-huh.
I've already gotten to that part. It's not very good.
Oh, are you kidding? That's like... You have to think about it metaphorically. Oh, hi!
Iris. Iris, have you told him yet?
She goes very, very blue and kind of looks away and she's like, it hasn't come up yet. Why?
Can you say that part again about what Cypress did to the people around him?
They started swaying to the music, and when he disappeared, they went back to normal like nothing happened.
And he looks back to Iris like super, like, he's like, yeah, yeah.
Did I leave that part out earlier?
Marissa may not have caught it because Marissa is tired, and I'm sorry.
No, it's okay.
Iris could have been tired too.
I mean, she was dealing with some stuff. She kind of looks at Maple and looks at Maurice, and she, like, there's a little bit of, like, black in the blue colors now.
Do you know him?
I don't, but we have to find him immediately. Can you, you said that rose is from him. Can we use that to track him or something?
Yeah, both roses are probably for him. I mean, if we want to find him, I could probably be bait.
He seems
interested.
I wouldn't want to put you through that, but if that's our best option, can we do it now? Can we go now?
I mean, I could probably bait him out.
Iris, you...
What? Repeat that?
Iris, you should tell him.
Okay, fine. So, Quinn, you remember my little sister, Nyx? She's been missing for 3 months. She's one of the children that are gone.
It's terrible.
I didn't want to say anything because I didn't want to seem like I was over eager or too invested in the mission, but I...
Did you see how she was taken? Is this why... certain it was him?
I don't know. My mom said that they were walking in the market and she was holding her hand, and then all of a sudden she wasn't and she was gone. But I mean, Nyx and I used to sing together sometimes. She had that thing where you could see colors and songs.
Okay.
I'm blanking on the actual word for that, but
synesthesia.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I would like to make the argument that Quinn knew that the kid was missing.
Yeah, I feel like you would have if you talked to like, my family, you know.
Well, my mom's your mom's best friend, so like...
She'd probably freak out to her.
Yeah.
Yeah, you would have known then.
Okay. So Quinn doesn't seem surprised. He just nods slowly and frowns.
Okay, well, the place where I saw him wasn't too far from the temple. I could probably just go back there and start screaming.
7 bitch!
I mean, if he is really stalking me, then it should work if I just go back and start freaking out.
I mean, are you sure? I know, I don't pretend not to know how dangerous this is for you.
It should be fine if everyone's there.
Yeah.
Well, what prevents us all from falling into the same kind of effect?
Nothing. Was there a range?
I was pretty close.
How far out were people listening?
10 feet? 20 feet?
I don't know if you were paying enough attention.
Yeah.
I mean, there's mostly a crowd around him.
Yeah, I wasn't really...
I don't know if
you're watching for that. I don't know.
Well, I can be invisible nearby.
I mean, I was able to fight off the first time. I'm not sure about this time.
Sometimes people are stronger than others.
Yeah. Do we want to do this tonight? Is everyone good?
Sounds pressing.
Where's Nadinia?
Probably playing with her fucking dog. I'll go get her.
Okay.
And I go back into the room and get Nadinia.
Hey, you come back in to see her, like out of the scraps of sheets, trying her best to make a bed for him in the corner.
He tore up your bed. See, this is where you're failing. He tore up your bed. You don't reward him with his own bed.
I'm showing him where he sleeps from now on.
Okay. Come on, we have to go.
What's wrong?
Something bitch boy barred in the lobby. Not lobby. Maple's gonna go scream.
Okay. So, Quinn, I appreciate you as a friend.
Fuck off, no you don't.
Alright, fine. Never mind. Never mind. Alright, let's go then.
He looks like he feels bad about that, but he doesn't say.
Grab my harpoon. Am I going to need to stab people?
Almost certainly.
I better get the sword, too. And out of my stuff, I pull out my greatsword. Put that on my back. Alright, let's do this. And I follow. Kind of head into the room, like walk into the room. So who am I stabbing and why?
Well, should probably explain what we're doing.
Cypress kidnapping children.
Got it.
I just hold up a rose. I have a stalker.
Also Cypress. Also.
Why is it that everybody else gets the cool stuff?
What?
You're stupid as hell.
I'm sorry, do you want to get kidnapped?
I want a stalker.
What?
Hey, I've never known what it's like to get stalked.
It's not fun.
You're terrified.
Well, how about this? You can get to stab the stalker that kidnapped my sister. That's going to be a much better experience for you.
Wait, Iris, this guy took your sister?
Yes.
Why didn't you say something? Let's go.
She's, like, close to tears and is just very overwhelmed with her new friends. Yay.
Is that Iris or Marissa?
Both.
Let's go. I mean, like, we gotta stab people.
When you gotta stab, you gotta stab.
Hey.
By the way, your sister, like, how old is she?
She's 10?
Oh. Oh, okay.
So before we leave.
Okay, this guy was asking to die. Got it.
Before we leave, I'm gonna tell you where I'm gonna be. Because if he's maybe watching the temple and he sees all of us leave.
Alright, then get out of here.
Yeah. She tells him, like, exactly where it's gonna be. And then, holding the roses in her hands, leaves the temple.
Maurice, is there a way out from, like, the back or something?
Yeah, do you want me to...
Do we want you to come?
Either that or I could try to hunt down Val.
Actually, I would rather you two stay here and watch the place, and watch specifically, like, the room.
Is it alright for me to go in y'all ladies' rooms? I don't want to be presumptuous.
Oh, I don't care. You can go in whenever.
It's fine.
Okay.
Kira, you could come into my room anytime.
Apparently, no. Is that somewhere else, maybe?
There's multiple roommates.
Put a sock on the door.
Because I know for sure Maple would be like, can you fucking leave?
Can you fucking not hear?
Like, literally, no, she'll
not,
take her
not
stick
fucking
and start
here.
Hitting you.
Yeah.
Alright. So he will stay there. He's giving Val a call as you guys. And how are you guys
Okay, can you turn other people invisible and you wear your hat?
Yes, I have. Yeah, I could turn someone else invisible.
I would turn the one in armor invisible.
Alright. Come here.
Hold up my hand.
I make you invisible for an hour.
You can't see it, but I'm flipping you off right now.
You're probably flipping me off right now. Stop it.
Girl after.
And then
Quinn's heart.
Then I change my appearance into, like, a peasant woman, or what a rich person would think a peasant woman looks like, which is
you
bad.
Are in the upper reach,
and we're not going down to the lower reach.
Okay, I thought we were going to lower reach. Never mind. My bad.
Nope. You turn yourself into a peasant it's woman. Not very realize far that's from stupid. The and turn yourself back.
Well, I could change as many times as I want because I have a hat. Okay. Well, then I will change into something different than I usually change into, and that is me. So.
Why do you like changing faces so much?
Because it's required.
You're literally asking.
But it's always.
Nope.
It's always your first. It's always your first go-to.
Nadinia, that is a very wonderful, psychologically rich vein to pursue. I don't think we have the time for that right now.
Thank you.
You're invisible for walking. 58 minutes.
We're walking.
Also,
I'm bored.
Also, I'm colorful. How do I not be that?
Become an emotionless blob.
I literally can't. And she's like bright fucking blue and orange.
Pat.
It's easy. You want to not change colors? Think about how your sister got captured and keep thinking about it.
She turns pitch fucking black.
There you go.
I've only seen her do that like once, dude.
There you go.
I'm sorry.
That means she's mad, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Quinn like gives her a bit of a burp of like, nope.
Yeah, no. This is how we want her.
Why?
Because then she blends in more.
I am the knight, apparently.
I don't think so, because she doesn't completely turn black.
It's better than being blue and orange.
That's fair. I
still
guess
bad.
You could probably take a nice cloak to kind of hide a bit.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, cool. I have a really cool cloak, and I'm consumed with, what does my mood sheet say? Absolute and utter rage.
Yikes.
Also, having a healer in the angriest form a healer can be is the scariest thing you've ever seen, because mm-hmm. they have access to things like called instead of cure wounds, inflict wounds.
Oh, I defo have that spell.
Yeah,
right,
it's Galena's. It's Galena's favorite combat spell.
Have you ever seen a healer try to heal someone and it just came out as inflict wounds and they go, oh no, I don't know what happened.
Okay, let's try to find the ending point here.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's getting late.
Yeah.
I think right. This is a good spot, honestly.
Are you guys just about to head out?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I honestly think that's probably a good spot for it, too.
What did you want to do?
I'd rather end, like, right before a combat,
if it's gonna happen.
Because, like, it's gonna be fucking freaked out for a week. I'm just gonna be so anxious for an entire week.
I will tell you that the ending point that I had in mind is not going to help.
Okay.
Oh, but I love cliffhangers, though.
I don't like these types.
What, you'd rather end on children being dead?
Oh god, no.
Jamie? You like that ending?
You like that? You like dead children?
Jesus.
But.
It was good. I will say,
I do think it's. Oh, thank you. I do think it would be less anxiety inducing to end it here than where I had in mind.
I mean, if Maple gets kidnapped, that, I mean, I'm totally.
We will
not be anxious
you.
About that.
All right.
But, yeah,
if Maple gets kidnapped, if Maple gets kidnapped, there is no force on this earth that will stop me from finishing the butt and driving it right into wherever the fuck she's captured in.
That's the worst fucking
I will finish the butt.
Yeah.
The butt's going after boys.
Alicia, I realized what the fuck you were doing after I got the rose, and I was like, wait, no. He is tied into that, and they're probably, oh no. And then there was the second rose, and I'm like, oh god, this probably very much was happening.
Tell me your secret! I want to know!
Am I right? Am I close?
I don't know exactly what you're talking
about. Okay,
you said a lot of vague words.
I'll end the VOD, and I'll send you a message. You have to confirm or deny, because I need to know.
I was going to say, I think I know, but it was kind of vague, so I'm worried that I don't.
Mm-hmm.
You know what you should send, Alicia? Maybe.
Don't. I will literally. Chris does that to me, and I will end his life.
No, I see that response for Marissa.
Fuck you! I have notes, come on! Don't do this, don't punish me for being a good D&D player.
Hey, Marissa, I finished the first season, finally.
Oh, did you? I'm so proud of you.
Thank you.
There's a horror podcast that we listen to called The Magnus Archives.
Oh yeah, I've seen a lot.
Marissa's on like it's so fucking good.
Yeah.
Marissa's on like 130 something.
I'm on 100. Look, this weekend I died and did not leave my bed for 3 days, so I binged.
Oh.
Yeah,
I'm on 105 something, and Alex is on like
40.
That's your fault. I told you before. I told Marissa.
Okay, you both have jobs where you can listen while you work.
True.
I can't.
That's
true. I'm trying.
Talking to Nick was the highlight of my night tonight.
That was beautiful.
Fucking
as soon as you said, like, as we were like stationed at the place, and you're like, and she says romance, I'm like, uh oh, like who's gonna show up? But
I have been sitting on that for so long. I was so excited for that mission.
That was such a clusterfuck. Oh my god.
Yeah.
And I like how two of us said straight to their face that we knew exactly what they were doing, and they just tried to play it off.
Yeah.
Not only we know what you're doing, listen, but we don't care. And they're like, oh, no, we're not doing that.
Quinn has only the highest caliber of members in his former group.
Yes, crack team.
Mm-hmm.
Only
there's
the
a reason we're
Hey,
the
Alicia.
B team of Red Rock.
Did we level?
No, we leveled last time.
You did not level last time, but not right now since you started off something up. After this.
Maybe.
I'm after sorry. I get kidnapped. After I get kidnapped. Okay.
Okay, that's fine.
It's fine. Totally fine. Everything's gonna be fine. I'm totally not gonna get, like, fucking charmed and then taken away.
It's fine. It's not like I've ever kidnapped a player and had them marry a Rakasha.
Shut the fuck up right now. We don't talk about that. We don't talk about that.
You know, someone's lawful good paladin of Lathander didn't marry a Rakasha.
It wasn't marriage, first of all. It was just a ring. There was no ceremony, firstly.
But there was an officiant.
Shut up. He was cool. He was the only cool dude.
No, you were the officiant. You're a fucking
paladin. Fuck, that's right. Damn it, I thought you had he was the witness.
It was me.
No, the pit demon was a witness.
The pit demon.
The pit demon was chill.
He was. Everyone really liked the pit demon, but God, did they hate the Rakasha.
Hmm. Well, yeah, because of that shit, I almost killed fucking Lenore.
It was great.
Great fucking... is an interesting word that I would use for that situation. No, listen, because here's what happened. Alicia was like, oh, here's this ring that, like, makes this demon control your character.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, I was sent into a real-life panic spiral because I'm like, oh, but I can't give it away in the real zone. But, like, it
you had nothing to worry about. Everyone's stupid.
I know.
Yeah, but that doesn't always work.
Listen,
everyone
it's okay.
Being stupid.
I'm very much like you and have, like, 7 different, like, what-ifs happening, like, at this current moment.
Yep. I'm, like, oh. Red String Brigade all the way.
Mm-hmm. Did you end the thing yet?
Oh, no, I haven't. I'll do that right now.
I want your message.
I will.